Yo, what's up YouTube? Welcome back to another art tutorial. So yeah, we're back at it doing photo cartoons, but in today's sessions we'll be doing things a little bit different because we'll be using both Adobe Illustrator and Adobe Photoshop to do our photo cartoon. So yeah, let's hop into Photoshop. Yeah, here's the photo of DMX, the rest in peace. So what I'll be doing here, I'll be tracing this photo to remain with the picture. I don't need the background. So let me fast forward the process. We are done with the photo. We don't need the one with the background. So what we're gonna do now is you're gonna separate the head from the body. To do this, you're gonna use the pen tool again, trace around the head. Zoom in. Right click, make selection, yes, Control J to make a duplicate. No, Control J to make a duplicate. You gotta make sure that you are on the layer that you're duplicating from. So yeah, here is our head. What you're gonna do next is select the body. Let's hide the head first, you don't need it for now. Zoom in. You're gonna remove this head. Selection, yes, then delete. We still have our head. What you're gonna do is select the body, then press Control T. Control T to have the transformations for this body only. What you're gonna do, hold shift and up, then decrease the size of the body. select the head, move it close, let's navigate there, select the body again, decrease the size again, select the body, come to filter, liquify, then select the up to zoom in, and try to make neck a little bit longer. Yes. Yeah, press Ctrl T again, then select the tool, zoom in. This tool allows you to edit. You can transform it into however you want it to be. Press this, bring it. Press the size of the head. Select the head, go to filter, liquify, zoom in, yeah. Make sure that all this sides are linked by using this thing between them. Okay, what you're gonna do, resize the eyes, want them to be big, height to be big, want them to be this big. Ah, I think this will do. And the distance, this distance will do for me. Go to the nose height, bring it like this, it's width, I'll make it tiny. Go for the mouth, I don't need a shade. think that will be okay with me. Can edit it however you want it to be. After that, I'm gonna save it, then export it to. I'm gonna save it. A JPEG is fine. DMX. Save. Open Illustrator. Create new file. Normally I use my measurements to be 210 by 210, my color mode RGB, then I create, okay. Here is my file. Go to open. Look for my photo. Here it is. Open it. Okay. I'm gonna decrease its opacity. Not that much. Yeah, I think that will do. Lock it. Create a new layer, and since I'm using a mouse, I'll come here, select the lips tool, make an ellipse, then change this color to black, zoom into it. Selecting the stroke, I go to basic, new brush, add brush, okay, select my brush tool, and then see how that went. It should give you this smooth looking paint brush. What I'm gonna do next, excuse me, I'm gonna do the outlines. Yeah, I'm gonna fast forward since I've already covered out how to do the outlines. Okay, now we are done with the outlines. What we'll be doing, I'll make sure that select the rectangular tool, make sure the color is on top, and close this area so that when I add my color shade, they don't get contained. Yeah, well, select everything, go to object, expand appearance, then I merge. Yeah, everything is merged now. What I'm gonna do, copy the layer, lock the top layer, and yeah, we add the shade on this layer. Choose a suitable skin tone. I think that will do. Select the rectangular tool again. Right click, arrange, send to back. To see that we have done it right, when you look here, the outlines, the black outlines should be on top, should be visible, should be on top of the shade of the color we have just added. Next step, we select everything again, properties, we merge again, select everything, right click, and isolate selected groups, delete the color so that we remain with the color and the outlines only. Yeah, now we're gonna change the color of everything that's within the outlines to the color you want it to be. This t-shirt, I'm gonna make it a little bit blue, dark blue, very dark blue. Let's see how that looks. A little bit dark. That dark will do, and the ring. Oh gosh! Because of this space here, when I select this sheet here, it's gonna select everything. So you gotta make sure that every line includes, there's no spaces between the lines, because if that happens, our colors won't be maintained where you want them to be. So I have to restart the whole process. Control Z, yeah, zoom. Select the direct selection to zoom. Make sure there's no space. So what I have to do now, check other places. Wait, I'm gonna add two different colors. Again, select everything, object, expand appearance, merge, copy the layer, load the top layer, make sure the color is on top, look for a shade. Obviously it's gonna be a different shade from the last one. I think that will do. Select the rectangular tool, add the color, arrange, send to bed, check, select everything, list attack groups, delete outer layer, zoom, look for dark blue again, yeah, zoom again. I'm gonna make this a little bit. Make sure you don't select the outlines, just select where we have the colors. Recommend that you do not select everything at once, since here we have this section. If you select it at once and you make a mistake, you have to restart. So take it in parts, maybe do this part first, then another part until you finish the whole set. Okay, you are done here. Go to the necklace. Eyedropper tool, copy this color, so that you don't mess everything at the same time. Select, zoom, select. Oh, you see what I mean? I messed up there. Thank you. just find sugar brown. So it's this one. Yeah. T-shirt sugar bean. So starting from here. Yes, there we have our colored cartoon. Now it's time to add some shades. We don't want to put too much shades because you're making it more like a cartoon. No, oh, I forgot to do the lips. That's it. Go to layers or exit the isolation mode. Then make a copy. Lock the bottom one. Hide it. Then, oh, the first thing you want to do is look for all the black lines. So we started shading from here. Look all the black lines. Except for this top two. Make a copy. This will help us when you delete the color. You don't delete the outlines. You know, select the direction tool. after that, make a new layer, make sure it's below the line we should shade first. Okay, then the next thing you wanna do is lock the top layer so that we only remain with this layer in between. This layer we'll use it to add some shades to it. Yeah, just turn on our reference, then let's get the color shade, make it a little bit darker. Select our pencil tool. Let's see if okay, it can work for us. Turn off the color layer so that we only remain with our reference. Okay, I'll fast forward and do all the shades where I think I will need them. Now we are gonna add the shades on the t-shirt. Yeah, so first thing, eyedropper tool, select this color, then find more darker blue than the one that we have. Let's see if it's dark. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I think this black will do. Then, yeah, let's shoot. Yeah. trying to keep it as simple as you can. Yeah, I think that shades. Next thing we want to do is maybe a little bit of that's fine. Yeah, there are shades. Next we add the brighter ones. Drag the top layer. We created a new layer. The one we're just working on, select the color, let's make it a little bit brighter. Last one, let's see how it looks. Fix that. Thank you. Yeah. Okay, let's do final retouches. Pretty good, make a star, then use the arrows to select how many points you want, then hold control, then drag to make it be like that. Zoom out, create sounds, Yeah, I'm gonna do the lips. Yeah, there it is. Thank you for tuning in. Do not forget to subscribe, like, comment, and yeah, hit the notification bell. See you next time.